My name is Soumya and I work as IBM DataCap consultant with a US-based consulting firm. Okay, and you have experience on .NET, if I'm right, right?
No, I'm a Java guy. Would that be a problem?
Oh, you're a Java guy. Yeah, then a problem. DataCap is developed basically in the .NET framework, and as well as we do the customization, any customization in .NET. So
that's a good thing. So I lead a team, so I have a .NET guys reporting to me, so I should have them. This is more me understanding the product, so that should be okay. Yeah.
Okay. Fine. So, okay, to start with, this is what we would be covering in the training, the overview of DataCap, the process phase of document capture. This would be the basic document capture, not that it's directly to DataCap or any imaging is how it works. That's the basic of document capture. And we would also start with DataCap components, application development, desktop client, and we will also go to Taskmaster Web, which is the web part of DataCap, and also that DataCap Navigator, which has recently started with DataCap for more UI and interaction. So these are the major topics which we would be covering in the course.
Okay,
so this demo is basically we would tell what is exactly DataCap and what it is being used and how it can be used to help the business to process their document automation. So, okay, what is IBM DataCap? So, IBM DataCap is like any other imaging tool, which is used for capturing the information from a document. A document can be, example, application form from a bank or a ID proof, which would be submitting. Like a driver's license or a passport, and also some other documents like the hospital management documents. Pretty much any document which we would like to streamline based on converting it from hard copy to electronic copy, and also capturing the information out of the form is what exactly is the process which we would be doing with help of IBM DataCap. So IBM DataCap supports multiple channel for capturing these forms. So it could be from the physical document could come either through scanner, or somebody can upload from a mobile device. We could also do a connection to a fax or an email server so that we directly receive the documents so that it can be processed through. So these would be some of the input channels from which a document can get processed through. And DataCap uses specifically to read the data out of the form. It uses different methods of learning, like a text learning or text analytics, machine learning. These will help to identify the document as what it is type. If it's a passport, read a data of the form and identify it as passport, or read any other sample like a driver's license and say it is a driver's license. So it's like a first step is to do the classification of a form. So in order to do that, we would need to analyze the text, what is present on the document, so that we would be able to identify the form. And the next step is to read the data. That means read the fields, like the driver's license number, name, date of birth. If you take the application form, the address, first name, last name. So pretty much whatever the business requirement is to extract the data out of a form is what is the extraction process. So that means we can also do a structure-based recognition, and also we can do an unstructured document recognition. That means a structured document is exactly would be something like an application form where a standard is being followed across the whole domain. That means from whichever customer I'm getting the form, it's the same form, it's just a different information about the customer. So that means it's a standard form. So capturing that information is more easier than capturing it from an unstructured form. So if you take an unstructured form, a DL is an unstructured form, because if you take US, every state follows different DL. So that means I'm going to have variation in the document recognition, because there's no specific format being followed in one particular state. So that means I can have first name printed on one state in the first line, and I can have another state where the first name is getting printed in the bottom of the driver's license. So this is just one such example. So that means I'm going to have a variation in the form. So that is what we call it as unstructured form, from which we do an extraction of data. So why we use DataCap? From all the above 3 points, why we use DataCap is mainly to reduce manual intervention, and also to reduce the cost of storing the paper document. So that means by going to DataCap, you also go store the documents in a content repository. So that means we do not require any more paper storage of document. So that's a major, improvement where DataCap is can be used. The other way is reducing the labor, where somebody would be sitting in a normal space where you have just one screen where you just start typing the information about an application form, and then you go verify if the driver's license of that particular application form is exactly correct, or if the customer already exists, do I have to tag the same form? Or so I was explaining about the last step where the DataCap used for improving the reducing the paper storage of documents, and also improves the manual labor which is being currently used for processing the documents end to end. So this is the major part of why we use any imaging tool to process a document through from classifying till exporting the documents to content repository. So Krishna, you can stop me anywhere if you have any question. If not, I can proceed further.
Absolutely. Soumya, actually, from what DataCap offers, I have a good knowledge of it. So where I was going is, Soumya, is like a couple of things I wanted to check on, right? So again, this is great. If you could, one of the things I was interested with this training is the different components of the DataCap involved. One. And two, there are some of the forms that we would want to do POC on with our client. So that's why I wanted to kind of understand the reason I'm on this training is more to kind of understand the different components involved. And then if you could demo a small form as to how, okay, you know what, this is a form, and then this studio component of DataCab would help you extract the text. That would be a great start for me to kind of understand.
Yes,
I believe that's part of the demo, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So this demo is just introduction, and I think it's in the upfront section session. You would how
so today you'd be going over all the components, or what it's going to be like, advantages of DataCab, or
so today is just explaining what is there in DataCab and what we would be covering in the course. So it's just a high level introduction of what is DataCab and what we would be covering in the future.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Okay. So these are the phases of the document capture, where we have an input, process, and output phase. We input the document, capture the data, and store them. So that's the that means I have to first input the document and then apply some rule to classify the document it as whatever its type as, an application form or a driver's license or a passport, whatever type it is going to be. And then if there is required, we would also do manual verification of data being captured by DataCab. And the final step is storing the documents along with the properties to a storage device. It could be content repository like FileNet or content manager, or you could also store it in a folder or a database, like whatever is a storage device for a particular customer. So that would be the last step of the document from DataCab.
Okay.
Right. So these are the components available in DataCab. DataCab server, which is the heart of DataCab, I would say, where Windows server is runs, which is used for running the any application of DataCab. So this is like a server which runs in the background all the time when you have to run your application or configure your application or create a new application. For any of the process, you need a DataCab server to be executed. Next comes DataCab clients. The DataCab clients are one small DataCab client which we use is DataCab Desktop. It's a Windows-based form where we use, we can do a scanning, or we can also do a verification of data. So that means that's a Windows-based component. It's called as DataCab Desktop. That's a client which is used for scanning or verification of data. Next comes DataCab Studio. Studio is the application development environment where we would use Studio for creating an application and configuring an application from end to end. So this is where we write our rules, create fields, apply logic for extracting the data, apply validation for any specific fields, and also write rules for exporting the document along with the properties being extracted to any other content repository. Next is DataCab Maintenance Manager. So this can be categorized as a couple of tools of maintenance manager available. So one such one we use often is the Nino, where it is used for cleaning up of data, cleaning up of batches created in DataCab. So that means we need to config. It is also a task scheduler, which we would be configuring to delete a batch or rerun a batch which has been aborted or which has been put on hold, or you send an email to a certain set of groups saying this particular batch is pending or this particular batch is aborted for somebody has to go look at the batch. So such things can be done by DataCup maintenance manager. Next is DataCup rule runner server. This is the another major component which we would be using for executing the batches in the background. So that means this is where we use to create a batch or to create any to run any rules which has been created in DataCap Studio in the background process, so that we don't need any manual step other than scan or verification. So rule runner server can be configured with multiple threads where you can run multiple batches in parallel, so that you have multiple process going on at the same time. That means I can do a scan and I can also do another task in parallel with another thread. So that means it's running in the background. So there is a parallel processing which has been happening. Next is DataCap web server. So this is this we call in a short form as TM web. This is the place we configure our workflow, DataCap workflow, jobs, tasks, and also you can run a batch or verify a batch. You can scan documents in the web server, TM web. So it is like DataCap clients and DataCap web server we can use for scanning and also do a verification of documents. Next is the DataCap web service. So DataCap web service is short form, we call it as WTM. So that has been created and we can host that web service to catch or to retrieve batch information, or we can also do a background batch upload, execute the batch in the background. So it is more like a web service which is available to retrieve batch information, or you can create a new batch. DataCap Windows service is the Taskmaster server. All those comes under DataCap Windows service, where we run those as a Windows service in the background. Then the DataCap report viewer is the where there are basic reports which we can configure for DataCap to retrieve the batch information, what has been executed. So these are the major components available in DataCap.
Yeah.
Okay. So going in depth, DataCap application development. So we use DStudio to create a DataCap application and also create a document hierarchy, which would have batch, document, page, and fields. Now that's what is document hierarchy usually will be, so that means we used to get the business requirement based on the structure. So that means what my batch has to be, that's an application name, and what is your document, how many document types you have, those many documents you would be creating for a specific business, and how many pages you have in each batch. Is it a single page or it's a multiple page, or how many supporting documents you have, and also how many fields you have for each page. So those will be created in DStudio, and we call it as document hierarchy, and we use this DStudio to create our rule sets, which consist of rules, actions, and functions. That means, so one small example of a rule set is, I want to upload an image from this particular folder. That's one rule which we have to write. That means we are doing a file import process. So one small example. So that means DataCup Studio is pretty much used for application development for a document lifecycle, starting from file import. Next is identifying the document or classifying the document, extraction of data, validation, verification, and exporting of data. So that is where DataCup Studio is used. Okay, so going in depth, how we get the documents, or what are the challenges in getting the documents. So we usually get a specific document, some amount of document set of one specific document type. So that means a document type can have multiple variation depending on their business, or it can have just one format which has been followed across the business. So usually most of the customer follow multiple variation because of geographical changes. So that's the biggest challenge in our imaging world, where we have to get what are the variation available on each of the document type upfront, so that we can suggest what method we are going to use for classifying a document or extraction of data. And also, this would really help in terms of improvement in extraction of data. So we usually suggest customers to give like minimum of 50 different variation of samples, so that we can go through each of them and identify what it requires to extract and identify this particular document. So this is the document capture process in high level. A scan, we can also do a file import, but in DataCup we call it as vscan only, even for the file import process. So that's an input. Next is the recognition, where we do a identifying of a document or a classification of a document.
Yes, Soumya, sorry to interrupt. Vscan means, yeah. What is vscan?
Vscan is virtual scan. Virtual scan is the uploading of document from a folder or a network share.
Okay, the documents will be getting in the share folder, right? You are saying
documents would be placed in a shared drive, and DataCup would be configured to pick up the document from the shared drive.
Okay, in the shared drive already the scan documents will be available in the vscan. Right?
Yeah, for the vscan process, right?
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Yeah. So recognition is categorized in couple of steps. One is the identifying of the document as what it is type exactly, and then the next is extraction of content from the document. Whatever fields you have to extract, those would be part of the recognition step. Then comes the verify, where it can be a manual step, or you can skip this step. This is an optional step. It depends on customers to customer, where a screen would be provided using DataCup clients or DataCup web, which is TM web, where you can do a verification of data before it gets exported to any repository. A document along with whatever has been extracted by the DataCup process would be displayed for users or customers to do the verification. The last step is export, where you can export the document to any repository of choice. It is a customer choice of where the document has to be exported to.
One doubt, the recognition means it will, how can it will be reading OCRs through the OCRs, right?
Yes, recognition would involve extract identifying of data and extraction of data either by optical character recognition, which is OCR, or OMR, or ICR, which, so that means we would have to decide what is the data which is getting on the form, which is an input. So the machine printed data is called optical character data, which is optical character recognition would be applied. OMR is like a form where you will have a tick mark or a cross. This is more like a survey where you will have to recognize that. So that means it falls under OMR. And ICR is more of manually entered data. That means human entered data, not with any machine. So that's the ICR.
Handwritten documents, right?
Handwritten documents. Right. So that would be decided based on the type of inputs you get for the process. So the probability of OMR and OCR is less. The probability of recognition of data by the ICR and the OMR is very, very less than OCR. It's because of the engines available with the data cap.
Okay, in which scenario you can go for this OMR, means like the tick mark you were saying, right? With real-time scenarios.
Like the survey document where you will have two boxes where you have yes or no, you just do a tick for yes, and for no, you just do another tick, right? So that's a scenario where you choose OMR for a particular field. Because you'll have it's not a character which you have to read, but it's a mark which you need to recognize. Is it yes or no? Okay. So going ahead, this is the detailed data cap workflow diagram, where how the document process happens. As explained, it's a scan, fax, email, or MFD is a first step. The next step comes under rules processing, where we do image cleanup, classify the document, locate fields or data, which recognition, applies business rules. So these are the steps where we do majorly in the background to extract, identify and extract the content from the document and apply any validations required for a particular field. Next is the verify, where this step is, as I said, it's going to be optional, and you can do optional for certain set of document, and you can do skip verify for certain set of document. That means you can apply a rule. If the rule is success, you would skip verify. If the rule is not success, you will have to go through verify. So such conditions can be applied for a verification process. The next is export. As I explained, it goes to an image repository for any for the storage of document along with the properties which has been read by the whole process. Okay, so coming to DataCap Desktop, is a client application where you can log in and retrieve batch information using the queue monitor, and you can also create a batch for scanning or file import process, which you can do manually, and you can also do a verify step in the DataCap desktop. That means it's a Windows-based verification which would have to be set up. So DataCap web, as I explained, it's a web client. It runs in IIS, and we use DataCap web for configuring the workflow and configuring the tasks, and also we user can have access to the job monitor, using which user can create a batch or scan a document and verifying the document. Next comes DataCap Navigator. DataCap Navigator is another web client, is been created recently using IBM Content Navigator, which has a rich UI for verifying data. So that means there's some component not available in DataCap TM web are available here, which will give customers more enhanced feature to look at the document. Like this one has Deja Viewer, if any of you know about it. It's a viewer where the documents are shown for the users. The viewer has certain set of features which are more elegant for the users to use them. DataCap Navigator is addition to DataCap. So that means it doesn't, if you just purchase DataCap, it does not comes along. TM web alone comes along. DataCap Navigator has to be a different component which needs to be configured for DataCap application separately. Okay, so that's about the initial set of details on what is DataCap and what are the components available in DataCap. Anyone has any question?
Something I mean, like how much of customization is needed that we have to write in .NET? How much of it does the tool do automatically?
So it actually merely depends on the customer's requirement first.
But
generally many actions are actually integrated in the latest version of DataCap, though not in the previous versions. Many actions are integrated and you can utilize the out-of-box actions to do. But still there are some requirements where we need to do one example is you need to do a complex regular expression and apply some logic to validate a data being recognized before it has been shown to the user or exported. So some complex things definitely require customization.
Thanks, Amy.